property.
County Life at Home, and we have a very special show for us today. Mary Jane, where are you today?
Well, I am on my deck outside my other comfort zone, and it's such a gorgeous day outside. How can we not do something in an outdoor activity where we're still in a stay home, stay safe environment? I'm here all by myself on my deck, but it's a few bugs, a little traffic noise, but it's a glorious day to be outside. But before we get started, I just wanted to mention the Rogers Sports and Media release, thanking the Hearts and Smiles campaign. And it's a thank you, Canada, for your overwhelming support for the Hearts and Smiles. Your generosity and kindness in recognizing frontline healthcare workers has made a significant impact in the fight against COVID-19. And we're all working really hard about that. So the total is $700,000 that has been raised already in support of the frontline fund. And that's only after one day. $700,000.
And wow.
What they're doing is they sold a limited edition of 150,000 Hearts and Smiles t-shirts and face masks. And you can go to heartsandsmiles.ca for the website. The Frontline is a national charity, and it provides frontline workers all across Canada with personal protective equipment, resources, and supplies, including hotel rooms when they have to self-isolate, and mental health services, which is also really important. And of course, some of the money also goes to helping to develop a vaccine for COVID-19. And we're all waiting for that. So we absolutely appreciate all the funds that are coming in to support that. And because our frontline workers, they're fearless warriors, they have our backs. Now we need to have theirs. So that is the Rogers Sports and Media release. And it's acknowledging all the effort from our frontline workers to help keep our community safe. That is so important. I also wanted to mention that as we, even if we're staying home, and as some of the businesses they're starting to open up, it's so important for us to spend our money in our local community to support our friends, our neighbors, in their employment or in their small businesses. It's really important to support them. May is also Museum Month, so check out online your local museums because they have programs and information, also your art galleries as well. And one of the things that Rhonda and I have had to do over the past few weeks is to make peace with the stay home, stay safe. And we've been coming up with different things and different ways of not only entertaining ourselves, but entertaining the viewers on our great County Life at Home. And one of the things, now that the weather is so nice, we want to be outside. And just a helpful hint, because we still have to stay in our own backyards. One of the things is to set up an obstacle course for your children, or the word children doesn't have an age limit to it. So anyone who is interested in setting up a backyard obstacle course or a little mini Olympics, gardening, and for us, it's our rock gardens and pulling weeds, anything that keeps us outdoor and active. But today we have a special guest, Emily, and we're going to be doing Zumba, and I'm going to do Zumba on my deck. Where are you, Rhonda? Where are you going to Zumba?
Well, I have stayed to the confines of my house because I live in town and I have neighbors a lot closer than you do, Mary Jane. So we don't want to share this quite yet till I get a little bit of skill involved, okay? But yeah, it's this kind of goes along with the comments that we made last week that, you know, music and dancing and moving and, you know, being lively is a great way to combat those kind of feelings that kind of come up, especially in times when we've been self-isolating for so long. So this is, I thought of Miss Emily Pierson, who's been doing Zumba in our community for quite some time. And she is an absolute glowing, happy, wonderful person, soul in our community. And she spreads joy everywhere she goes. So I thought we've got to get Miss Emily on the show. She can show us some moves and we can talk about Zumba. So I think Miss Mary Jane, I think this is going to be a lot of fun. It might be the start of something that's going to be a lifelong practice for the two of us, I hope.
Well, Rhonda, you always make me feel brave, no matter what it is. You get me involved in doing things that I wouldn't normally be doing. But I appreciate the fact that Emily is here to give us an opportunity for me to learn something new.
Awesome. So, Miss Emily, how are you today?
Hi, guys. Thanks for having me on the show. This is great.
So, Emily, can you tell us, let our watchers, our viewers know, okay, how long have you been doing Zumba? And first of all, what is Zumba and how does it help our people?
Okay, so Zumba is a dance fitness workout. It was founded by a man named Beto in Colombia, and it's inspired by Latin music and styles, but also it's worldly music from India and Africa, and it's a lot of fun. It's a great way to have a good workout and get your smiles going and just have a good time. I've been a ballet dancer since I was little. And then in 2014, I started Zumba and I have loved it ever since.
Awesome. So are there classes that you had to take, or is there a designation, or is this something that's pretty open? And, you know, whereabouts do you teach, or do you know, what kind of experience have you had with it? Where have you taken it?
Well, I started doing some classes locally just as a participant, and then I just really loved it so much that I got interested and found a way of getting my certificate in the city. And then I started doing classes on my own in Owen Sound, and I've done baby classes for moms with babies in the carrier. I've done kids classes. So right now, because we're self-isolating, I've been doing some online live Zoom, not Zoom, Facebook live classes on my Facebook page. So that's Emily Pierson, or you can go on to Owen Sound Zumba. That's my own personal Facebook group. And I do some classes there. You can check them out. And then when this is all over, I do have my own classes that I have weekly. So I would encourage anybody who loves to dance to try this form of workout, because it really just gets you moving and it's non-judgmental. So you can just feel free to do whatever. And if you can't keep up, it's just more about having fun. So just kind of go as, just take it as you go. And each time you come back to the classes, you'll get better and better because you'll hear the music and you'll remember the moves.
That sounds perfect, Emily. And I'll have to say, I kind of have two left feet, but I can't wait to get into this. And I think Mary Jane and I are going to be attending some classes later. So do you want to get ready and start, show us some moves and get us loosened up and ready for our first Zumba? And everybody at home, by all means, get up, turn the music up, because you're going to want to dance.
For sure. So I always tell my class that if you can't follow what I'm doing with my whole body, to just pick either my upper half or my bottom half and just to follow that, because it can get kind of fast and complicated. So I'll show you a few moves first that are examples from the songs that I'll be doing, and then I'll do the songs. And one is actually a traditional Zumba song, and the other one is more fun, and the kids will like this one. So I think you'll enjoy it, hopefully.
I think we will, and it's going to get people up off the couch, up off the Netflix, because I got to say, I might have been doing a lot of that. So this is going to be fantastic. All right, Mary Jane, we'll be watching for you.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to leave my jacket on. It's just a little bit cool out here yet.
Okay, so the first style I'm going to show you, can you see me okay?
Yes, we can perfectly.
Okay. The first style I'm going to show you is a salsa. So it basically, you take one step out and then a baby step and then back. So step out, baby step back. Step out, baby step back. And then when you get good at that, you can move your hips. So out and out. The hip goes out towards the foot that is leading. So that's the first one. The second one I want to show you is called cumbia. And you put your foot behind you like this, and you kind of step up on the ball of your foot and then come back down again. It's kind of like a little trot. So when you get going fast, it looks like this. And then you can put your hand on your hip, and this hand goes like this, and then you can move your hips around like this. And that's called cumbia.
Emily, I understand now what you mean by maybe doing the feet or the top at one time, because yeah, that makes me feel like I'm pretty slow in the head, actually, to coordinate all those body parts. But it does look like a good move.
Well, just keep on smiling. It's okay. The next one is called the reggaeton, and it's when you put your foot out like this. It's like you're going to walk, but you kind of stop yourself. It's pretty easy. It's more like a stomp. And then you take your arms, and when you bring them up. So stomp and bring them up. Like that. And then the last one I'm going to show you is called the flamenco. And it's basically where you just put your... You put your foot behind you, just like the cumbia, except for you're going to move your body to the corner. So it's just like this. Pretty basic. And then if you get your arms going, put them in front of you, and then take them out with the leading foot. Just like that. So those were four styles of... different techniques that you would use in a song, and you would have those repeating so that you get really good at them, and then they wouldn't be difficult anymore. So I'm going to put on a couple songs, and hopefully you'll enjoy them.
Are you ready, Mary Jane?
Oh, yes. I'm just picking up my notes. They're flying away.
Oh, okay.
Just give me the thumbs up if the music is at the right level.
Okay.
How are you doing, Mary Jane? Oh, good.
Shake, shake, shake. Yeah.
Traditional Zumba music that maybe the teenagers wouldn't be quite as interested in, but you can just get moving and bouncing around and shaking your body and listening to great upbeat happy music. I mean, how do you stay sad when you're doing Zumba, right, Mary Jane?
Well, I'm just really hoping that no one is taking their dog for a walk along the roadway here and to see me gyrating up here on the deck. But that was really fun. My heart rate is elevated, and that's a good thing. But I think it was the music that was just so inspiring and so upbeat. Like, how can you not smile?
That's right. It's such a good, healthy workout.
So closely that I couldn't actually respond to Rhonda when she was talking to me because I had to focus completely on the move that Emily was doing. They just, you're just so smooth, Emily, just so well choreographed.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, it's a really good exercise and a good way to stay fit, but also for our own mental health. It's good to be happy and move, and especially during these times, it's easy to get kind of down and you're doing the same thing over and you're stuck inside. But if you're just moving with good music, then it just lifts people's spirits and you have that blood flowing to your brain and lots of endorphins are being released. So it's an all around healthy workout for sure.
Oh yeah. But not only that, it's trying to keep up with you because you're skilled.
Well, you guys did an amazing job.
Oh, I'm not sure that I'm going to watch my portion of this video. I think I'm just going to focus on Emily and try and recapture the fun that I had with her today.
Well, I would love it if you could come to my class sometime.
Watch the episodes after we filmed them.
Emily, maybe you could show us a couple more of the moves, like some of the ones that you did with the Taylor Swift song, just so we can build our skill level up a wee bit for when we come to your class. We've got about 5 minutes left, so we could probably fit in another dance if we wanted to.
Sure. Well, I have one that I think would be really suited for the situation.
So leave me a minute at the end, Emily. Rhonda and Emily.
Okay, sounds good. Okay, so basically the moves for the Taylor Swift song is more moves that we would be using around here and not the worldly styles that I showed you earlier. So with the Taylor Swift, it's basically you're making sure you're in a stance and you're going from one side to the other. And even when you're standing here like this, you don't think it's really doing anything, but you can really engage your core. And that's a good exercise because you need to have a strong core for Zumba. And I always tell my class, keep your shoulders back. And you have you're able to breathe still, but you're tight in your core. So this move here, it doesn't seem like much, but it's still a good stretch and you're getting a core workout. So that's really important. And then just, it's a very high impact song, so you're constantly moving. And as long as you're moving, you're having a good time, you're burning calories, you're happy, it's an all-around good song. So I can do one more song for you. It's actually short, so I'll just put it on right now.
It's called I Like How It Feels. And this song reminds me of how we have to remember that even though there's, you know, things that are happening, that we are still in good spirits and there's things to be thankful for.
Perfect, Emily. Perfect timing.
Okay, here
it's
we go.
It's my time. It's my life. I can do what I like for the price of a smile. I gotta take it to ride so I keep living, cause it feels right and it's so nice. And I'll do it all again this time. It's forever, it gets better. And I like how it feels.
Exercise program, you want to have a smoothie, a protein shake, banana, soy milk, blueberries, and spinach all swished up together. It looks a little green, but it's absolutely delicious, and you want to combine something with that afterwards. So I drank a little bit of water through, but not too much. Because now I'm going to have my green looking smoothie.
So that is a, thank you so much, Emily, for coming and showing us how to dance our butts off and get into Zumba and have a happy way to start the day or finish the day. And Miss Mary Jane for pairing it with a very healthy drink. And be sure to join us next week. Who knows what we're going to be doing on Gray County Life at home. You just never know. So don't forget to tune in. We'll see you next week.
This program is brought to you by Ignite TV. Now you're in command. Visit Rogers.com for more details.
Call the Rogers TV viewer response line, email us, or connect with us on social media.
HealthLink connects home, community, and healthcare. Please join me for HealthLink on Rogers TV.
It's closing time, and you stayed out longer than you planned. So now you can't drive, and the buses have stopped running.